Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Selamat datang kembali di channel Dodi Sefriadi. Seperti biasa, di channel ini aku akan membahas hal-hal unik, menarik, bahkan menyeramkan. Namun sebelum kita mulai videonya, silakan klik tombol subscribe di bawah dan klik juga loncengnya sebagai notifikasi agar ketika saya mengupload video terbaru kalian mendapatkan pemberitahuan. Kali ini aku akan memperlihatkan kalian sebuah video ungkapan dari mantan Menteri Luar Negeri Arab Saudi yaitu Adel Al-Jubair mengenai negara Iran dan Syiahnya. Saya mencoba untuk mencari video lengkapnya ini, ternyata video lengkapnya sudah dihapus. Entah apa maksud dari pihak yang menghapusnya, mungkin karena memang untuk menghilangkan jejak digital atau bagaimana. Tapi yang pasti jejak digital itu sangat sulit dihapus. Kalaupun dihapus dari sosial media, akan ada yang tersisa walaupun sedikit. Itu guys ya, kalau jejak digital itu memang susah untuk dihapus. Kali ini saya tidak mereaction videonya karena durasinya cukup panjang, biar teman-teman bisa fokus melihat videonya, jadi saya tidak mereactionnya. Video ini berbahasa Inggris tapi sudah ada subtitlenya berbahasa Indonesia, jadi teman-teman bisa fokus ke subtitle tersebut agar mengerti penyampaian dari video itu guys ya. Langsung aja simak video berikut ini.
11 September, 15 people of that 19 was the Saudi citizens. So it seems that, and also now in this room, I think that many people also knows that which country or which countries has supported the Daesh for many years. Just I would like to mention that the thing that minister mentioned here is completely against and opposite to the policy of the European Union leaders and even United States that does have relations with Iran regarding the, especially the recent cases of the nuclear negotiation, and also the some kind of the relations that also Iran has with other regional countries shows that Iran also has some kind of the logical policy inviting Iran to present in the coalitions that for the things that for the solving the problem in Syria shows that Iran is a main partner for the solving the problem in the Syria. That's all.
Now on the third issue, the Honorable Consul General from Iran, I didn't say anything that was not based in fact. Doesn't the Iranian constitution say export the revolution? Doesn't the constitution say take care of the Shia, the dispossessed as you call them? Didn't Iran create Hezbollah? Didn't Iran attack more than a dozen embassies inside Iran in violation of all international laws? We didn't attack them. Iran did. Didn't Iran manage, plan, and execute the 1996 attack in Khobar Towers against the American Marines? Yes, they did. The control officer was Brigadier General Sharifi. You're a military attaché in Bahrain. The bomb maker was Hezbollah. The explosives came from the Bekaa Valley. The top three leaders of the plot escaped and have been living in Iran ever since. Isn't that sheltering terrorists? One of them we captured last year in Lebanon with an Iranian passport, not a Saudi passport, even though he's a Saudi citizen. Isn't that aiding and abetting terrorists? We didn't make this up. When the explosions in Riyadh happened in 2003, Saif al-Adel was in Iran along with Saad bin Laden, the chief propaganda person for Al-Qaeda, and four or five other people, senior leaders. Iran harbored them and protected them. We asked for them to be extradited. It was refused. Some of them are still in Iran. We didn't invent this. This is the fact. The order to blow up three housing compounds in Riyadh in 2003 was made by Saif al-Adel, chief of Al-Qaeda operations, while he was in Iran. We have the phone conversation on tape. We didn't make this up. Ronald Reagan used to say that facts are stubborn things. They are stubborn because we can't get around the fact. Hezbollah is a terrorist organization. Attacking embassies is very clear. They don't just blow themselves up. Somebody does it. Killing diplomats. Diplomats don't commit suicide. by shooting themselves 3 times? Somebody's responsible. Iranian agents have been linked to terrorist attacks in Europe, to terrorist attacks in South America. We didn't make this up. This is the world. This is evidence. And so, yes, we wish and hope that Iran, a great nation, can be a great neighbor to us. But it takes two to tango. It takes willingness to give up this expansionist, aggressive policies and return to international norms and behaviors if you want people to deal with you. And our hands is extended to Iran. It has been for 35 years. But what we get in return, a diplomat's killed, embassies blown up, terrorists. We have Iranian agents captured in Saudi Arabia for plotting terrorist attacks. We stopped 4 shipments of weapons that Iran was trying to smuggle to the Houthis in Yemen. We have explosives that Iran tried to smuggle into Saudi Arabia, Bahrain, Kuwait. This is not fiction. And this is not child's play. This is aggressive behavior. This is unacceptable behavior. This is behavior that violates all norms of international behavior and international law. That's why Iran is designated as a state sponsor of terrorism, and that's why Iran is sanctioned for its support of terrorism, not by us, by the international community. So could it be that the whole world is wrong and Iran is right? Could it be that maybe international law that says peaceful relations and non-interference in the affairs of others is wrong, and Iran's approach of aggressively pursuing your objective, irrespective of how you do it, is correct? I don't think so. So if you want a Saudi official to not be critical of Iran, behave in a way that doesn't expose you to criticism. And so far, your history has been one of death and destruction, disregard for international law, and disregard for principles that have existed since the advent of nations, which is good neighborliness and non-interference in the affairs of others.
Ya, teman-teman sudah simak tadi videonya. Seharusnya ini merupakan fakta yang harus diketahui oleh seluruh dunia. Tapi seperti yang saya katakan di awal, bahwa video aslinya ini saya tidak bisa menemukan. Justru saya menemukan informasi bahwa video ini sudah dihapus dari sosial media, dan seakan-akan memang untuk menghilangkan jejak dari video ini. Tetapi bagaimanapun juga, jejak digital itu sangat sulit sekali untuk dihilangkan. Kalaupun mau dihilangkan, itu tidak bisa hilang 100%. Akan ada yang tersisa beberapa persen. Mungkin teman-teman punya link lengkapnya mengenai video ini, bisa share linknya di kolom komentar, guys ya. Dan bagaimana pendapat teman-teman mengenai video ini? Coba tulis di kolom komentar. Oke, cukup sekian video kali ini. Masih akan ada lagi video lainnya yang akan saya upload di channel ini. Klik tombol subscribe di bawah dan klik juga loncengnya sebagai notifikasi agar ketika saya mengupload video terbaru kalian mendapatkan pemberitahuan. Jika kalian sudah klik tombol subscribe-nya, kita akan bertemu lagi tetap di channel Dodi Sefriadi. Sekian dari saya. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.